Bom.
Turn that shit off for a second. Hey people, this is DLF. Look what I got here. This is the new Waves Crashing piano chords, Sean Beard vinyl. I didn't open this yet. I'm doing unboxing of this. Not at this time though. Excuse the way I'm dressed right now. Believe it or not, I'm dressed like this. I'm dressed like this because I have a job interview in like an hour or wait. Well, I'm leaving here in about an hour, so we're gonna make this a short video. We're not gonna do the unboxing right now. But there's something there's something I learned just from like experience. Like, I figured out a way I can make like a ton of money by just doing really nothing. And, you know, I don't really see anything illegal about it. Like, I don't really see how it can really catch on to authorities or anything. Why would I explain it? And, you know, it's going to sound a little weird, but whatever, okay? Buffalo is close to Canada, okay? Like, I can get to Canada in, 15 minutes, you know, whatever. I ain't going in Buffalo, but... We have three bridges that go to Canada in the western New York area. We got the Peace Bridge, which is right on the west side here. It's, you know, that's pretty common. Then we got the Rainbow Bridge, which is up in Niagara Falls, about, I don't know, probably 20 miles up north from Buffalo. Maybe not even 20 miles, I don't know. But anyway, we got that one. And then we got the one that's further up north in Lewiston, Maine, where the Velmas hang out. But, you know, Lewiston, New York. Up there, it's called the Lewiston-Queenston Bridge up there. Anyway, I found this out. The first time I went up to Canada on my own, I had my video camera and all. It was on my birthday. And I know I went over to the Rainbow Bridge, and the one I said it was in Niagara Falls. That's where you go over the bridge, and it's like, it goes from Niagara Falls, New York to Niagara Falls, Ontario. And I noticed something about that. I didn't really notice it until few weeks ago, but you know what? Right when you go over that Rainbow Bridge in Canada, if you're going over Rainbow Bridge going into Canada, right at the end of the bridge, look to your right, okay? You'll see a blue booth there, like right on the side of the bridge. And you can go in there, and there's some girl in there that she'll take your American money and give you Canadian for it. So I went in there when I had my camera, I was filming it, and I went into that blue booth thing. I went in there with $60 American. She gave me $60 Canadian. Okay. And again, I the same thing. When I was about to come back over. To America again. I gave her, I forget how much I had that day. I think I had like $70 that I won some at the casino up there. So I think I had like $70 Canadian. So I gave that to her. She gives me back 70 American. All right. So what's the big deal? Okay. A few weeks ago, my mom took me up to Falls View Casino. It's the same casino that I filmed on that one video that went up to Canada. She took me up there a few weeks ago. You know, they had a concert up there. I didn't really want to see a concert. It was Train, okay? Fuck that. I'm not going to go see that shit. You know, Train the band. I don't know. Drops of Jupiter. I don't really know the fucking band that well. But my mom likes them, and she went up to go see them. And I noticed something. I went up there with... How much money did I want? $98 American I went up there with. Now, in those casinos up in Canada, you have to exchange your money to Canadian player play the games there. So she went to a casino, she went to a concert, and I just stayed in the casino part, and I just played pick'em poker. Well, anyway, I noticed something, that they exchange your money there as well at the casino. So I went up there with $98, okay? I went up to a cashier up there, and she gave me back $101 in Canadian. Do you see what I'm getting at here? Okay, well, the casino we went to was Falls View Casino. That's the one that's right across the street from the Skylon Tower. If you're at the casino I used to work at, if you're at that one and you're looking into Canada, you see that big tower there, that's a Skylon Tower. To the left of that Skylon Tower, if you're looking at, from America into Canada, you'll see a Skylon Tower, and then you'll see another building to the left that says casino up and down there. That's the Falls View. There's actually another casino that's almost right across that Rainbow Bridge. And it's called Casino Niagara. They're both owned by the same company. It's not Indians. It's just, I think it's just that the Canadian government owns it or something. But anyway, I noticed something. It was like, you know, people can make a lot of money doing this. Let's say I go in. Well, last time I went to that casino, I brought $98. I got $101 back. Okay, in Canadian. Let's make it even. Let's say I go in there with, I don't know, just an even 100. I have an even 100 American, okay? And let's go to the Casino Niagara, one that's right, like, right after that bridge there, you know? Go to Casino Niagara. Go in there and exchange that $100 bill for Canadian. You'll probably get, I don't know, you'll probably get like 103 or something back, approximately, at the casino. It'll give you back like 103 Canadian. Now, what if I took that 103 Canadian and went to that blue booth that I was talking about that's right next to the bridge? Since the last time I went, when I went on my own, I brought $60 of American, they gave me $60 Canadian. Then I think I won some at the casino, and I actually had $70 Canadian, and I went to the Blue Booth and got $70 American. Which means, if you give them $100 American, they'll give you $100 Canadian. If you give them $100 Canadian, they'll give you $100 American. But the casino, when they do it, they actually give it to you on par. The casino, they give it to you by the exchange rate. So what it is you bring $100 American to that casino, they'll give you, let's say, $103 Canadian. So you take that $103 Canadian, take it to the Blue Booth, they'll give you $103 American, okay? You just made $3. I know it's not a lot, but imagine this, keep going back and forth. Like, take a day, just go up to Canada, and just keep going back and forth between the casino and the Blue Booth. Yeah, it sounds tedious, but hey, if you're making money, you know, keep going back and forth, Blue Booth, keep going back, Casino, Blue Booth, just keep exchanging your money that way. I bet you by, like, if you start in the morning and end at, like, I don't know, 6 at night, I know it's boring, just keep going back and forth like that, but hey, I bet you if you did that all day, you'd end up with like $500. And just by walking back and forth between those two places. Now imagine, let's say you didn't bring $100. Let's say you brought, I don't know, $1,000 to do it with. Well, then it goes up even faster. You go to a casino, get an exchange, take it to the booth, and you keep going back and forth. I bet you by the end of the day, you'll have like, I don't know, 15 grand, wait, yeah, 15 grand at the end of the day. You know, that's, hey, I mean, that's good, I guess. I mean, you know, I think, I'm willing to try it. I don't really see how, if anyone can get in trouble for it, though. You know, I'm sure somebody could, like, I'm sure, like, if you keep going to this casino, you know, they'll probably catch on, like, after a while, but it's like, you know, you're not really doing anything illegal, as far as I know. It's just, you know, there's no, like, limit or anything to it, but who knows, you know. You know what I'm saying. It's, hey, but if you want to try it, be my guest. I might try it someday. I actually got a $20 coupon for Fallsview Casino, and it works for the Casino Niagara as well. $20 coupon for meals. See if I can find that real quick. I where is it now? I had it somewhere. It's buried under here. I don't know. It's buried. I don't know. Oh, here it is. Here it is. I'll put my finger over the address so no weirdos can get it, but I got that. And yeah, see, $20 voucher. Just show that, and then you can, yeah you can see that. See, because I'm Canadian now, you know. And you know. All right. So yeah, I might try that if I go up there one day with this, and yeah. Alright, well that's all I have to say for now. I mean, remember, you want to make money, you want to make some money fast, and it is pretty easy too, I would imagine. You might make some money fast or whatever. Do what I did. Just keep going back and forth to the casino. And the Blue Booth at the end of the bridge, and keep exchanging your money. You know, because that Blue Booth gives it to you on par, while the casino gives you the exchange rate equivalent. All right, so that's my trick for the day. All right, bye.